Hello guys, this is Sushant. Many of you guys who were in your 12th might have just done with your exams. Many of you will be going for your engineering studies, medical studies, pharmacy, and many more field. To enter into any field, you require an entrance exam to be given. For engineering, there are many entrance exams to be given like MHCET, JEE, BITSAT, etc. which depending on what exam you're giving, you will be entering into different colleges. In this video, we are discussing about the MHCET, which is going to be conducted on 11th of May 2017. So you can see that only about a month is remaining for the preparation for that exam. So let us go into the details of that exam. Many of the students will be giving this type of exam for the first time, in which you will be having only MCQs. So as you know, MCQs are multiple choice question in which you will be having four choices and only one answer is correct. So in this video, we are going to go into the crust of what basically MHCET is by decoding the different levels of MHCET and to understand basically how to do the preparation for this. So let us try to understand the pattern which the MHCET follows. On the date of exam, that is 11th May, there are going to be basically three papers. Paper 1, which is mathematics. Paper 2, which is physics and chemistry together. Paper 3 is biology, which is divided into two parts, that is zoology and botany. So depending on which field you want to choose, you will be taking up papers. If you are choosing for engineering, you have to give paper 1 and paper 2, which is mathematics, physics and chemistry. So we are going to discuss about what basically the pattern is going to be followed. Now in my paper 1, which is mathematics, you will be having 50 questions. Each question will be carrying 2 marks. So basically that paper 1 is for 100 marks. If you go for my physics and chemistry, which is my paper 2, it will be consisting of 50 questions for physics, 50 questions for chemistry. Each question will be for 1 mark, so totally paper 2 is also for 100 marks. Paper 3 will be in similar basis, it will be for 100 marks, in which 50 will be for zoology, 50 will be for botany. For paper 1, paper 2 and paper 3, you will be given 90 minutes to solve, that is 1.5 hours. So for paper 1, which consists of 50 questions, you will be given 90 minutes. For paper 2 and paper 3, there are 100 questions for which you have 90 minutes to solve. So to understand what basically this paper pattern requires is, it requires your speed and accuracy to solve the questions. Both speed and accuracy is going to determine your scoring in this particular examination. Now, whenever you are attempting and getting a right answer, you will be getting 2 marks if you are solving for paper 1. And for paper 2 and paper 3, that will be scoring you 1 mark. But if you get it wrong, then there are no negative marking for it. So that's a big plus point to it. Now let us try to understand how are you going to answer to the questions. You will be given ORS sheet to answer the questions. On this ORS sheet, you will be having, for each question, you will be having 4 bubbles. Each bubble will be representing the choice like A, B, C, D. In this bubble, you have to fill in with black pen, black ballpoint pen, your option, particular option. Like let us consider for question 3, you feel that the answer is going to be B, then you are going to take your ballpoint pen and color it fully. You should not leave any gap in the circle. So basically you have to fill that particular option by coloring the whole circle, and you have to keep in mind that you are not leaving any gap inside the circle. You have to be very careful by filling this up, because you have to try not to bring anything outside the circle. You have to totally fill that particular bubble to get your answer corrected. Once you have selected the option and you have colored or answered that particular option, then you cannot change that option. So you have to be very careful whenever you're choosing, because you cannot go and circle my C if that C you feel is the right answer. If you're going to circle C, then that question will be not checked and you will be given 0 for that particular question. So while choosing the option, you have to be very careful. The answer filling is to be done by black ballpoint pen only. No pencils or nothing will be accepted for that particular question. So after understanding how to answer a particular question, let us go for the syllabus. Now the syllabus for each paper is dependent on the 12th standard book only. So you have to refer to your 12th standard textbook only to give that particular examination. Apart from that, there is nothing else which is asked. Now let us go for the preparation part. How are you going to prepare for CET? Now, given that you have only 1 month of preparation left, you have to basically, you can categorize your chapters into three sections. The three sections can be divided into roughly like the chapters which you know thoroughly. So these will consist of the easy chapters and the chapters which you thought were tough and you practiced on it and you made it possible that you know it thoroughly. Now the second category of subject, that is the chapters which you are not sure about. It means you have practiced for it, but you are not able to answer to the questions given in that chapter. So that comes under the not sure chapter. And the last category, which is no idea, like these are the chapters which you might have left while you were studying for your 12th standard. Let us try to understand how to categorize the chapters. The first category of chapters will be including those chapters which whenever you are answering to those chapters, you are getting 80 to 90% of the problems right. So you can attempt those questions very easily and in a swift way. The second set of chapters are those set of chapters in which you are getting your answers about 60 to 70% right. And the last will be those set of chapters in which you cannot assume anything or you don't have any idea, or it is just you are bluffing those questions. The intention of making these categories is to understand your strength. You know that these particular set of chapters are your strength and they are going to fetch you the maximum amount of marks in CET. Because in CET, the more you score, the more is the chances of getting through with that exam. Because each and every mark is very important in that exam. So your main intention for the first 10 days is for any chapter or any subject, that is PCMB, should be that you have to make the lower category into the higher category chapters. Like this third category should be shifted to either the second category or the first category of first category chapters. And the second category of chapters should be shifted to the first category of chapters. So that when the exam date comes, you are very sure, pretty sure of number of questions which you are going to attempt, which is surely you are going to attempt it. If you are finding that in the second and the third category, the number of chapters are very large number, and the first category, there are very few chapters which you are sure about it, don't be scared. Your main intention should be to make the third category chapter into a second category chapter. Because once you are in the second category chapter, your probability of getting the answers are... Once you are in the second category of chapters, your probability of answering to the questions rises. Because in the third category, if you know there are four options, probability of getting the right answer is basically 1 by 4, which is 25% only. If you are little bit sure about that chapter or question, then you may be able to answer the question very properly rather than having no idea about that chapter. So it is better to have a clear, pretty much idea about that chapter than rather than not having any idea at all. So once it enters into my second category, what you can do is you can use your logic and you can do some analytical thinking by eliminating the wrong choices, because by pretty much now you will be able to eliminate the wrong choices in the particular question. Once that is done, once you have eliminated, like from the four options, if you could eliminate only one option, then your probability of getting a right answer from that will be 33%. So from 25, you have jumped directly to 33% of getting the right answer. If you could eliminate two options from it, so your probability of getting the question right is 50%. So by making that chapter, that is from third category, shifting it to the second category, it would very much help you to score. So at the end of 10 days, you should have very minimum amount of chapters in the third category. Once the categorization of the chapters is done and your upgrading of that chapter from the lower category to upper category is done, that is, you have to give this amount of time for 10 days only. After 10 days, you have to practice on your speed and accuracy. That is, you have to practice on solving a particular question in less amount of time, but getting it right also at the same time. Because MHCET is basically dependent on these two factors, that is speed and accuracy. It does not test much of your knowledge, but it tests how fast and how quickly you can answer to a particular question with a right answer. That is the main important point. Because if you are just speedy but you are not able to answer to the question, then you are obviously not going to score. And if you are accurate enough but you are not able to answer to many questions, then still also you are losing many of the marks. So your speed and accuracy is the main factor which will decide your MHCET score. The more you score, the more is the possibility of getting into a good college. Let us try to understand the type of questions which MHCET will be asking you. The questions will be repeated in nature. So that will be a plus point for you, because most of the questions you will be able to answer correctly right now at this stage, because you have just given your 12th standard exam. So almost 40 to 50% of the paper can be given by you without any hesitation. Your main intention is to reach the 80 and 90% target, like completing 80 to 90% of the paper, but in the time constraint also. So as we have discussed, you have to do that practicing only. I would suggest that daily you have a quota of almost minimum amount of 100 questions in whichever chapter you want to do for each subject. This will not only ensure your working with the questions, but also ensure your speed. Because those are the amount of questions which you will be answering in particular exam. Like in paper 2 and paper 3, you have to answer 200 questions in a time span of 1.5 hours. So this will ensure that you are able to solve that paper in a time constrained format, and also you are able to recollect to the set of questions and formulas which are asked in that particular question. Now some tips while attempting to any question. One thing you have to be very sure, if you are not getting any particular question, please don't get stuck on that particular question. You have to keep moving on to the next question if you are not getting that question. But if you are sure that you will be able to solve if you have time given for it, then please make a mark over there. So you can mark it with a star or a dot so that you are able to understand that you can come back to that question and attempt it when you have time. If the questions are such that you are not able to answer at all, like they come into the third category of your chapters, then please have a separate marking done for it. So when you're going back to the question again, you will be able to just bluff some of the answer from it. Yes, I'm just suggesting you to bluff, because in CET you have to remember that there are no negative marking, but the amount of bluff should also be limited, because whenever you are bluffing, there is a chance of 25% that you will get a 1 mark or a 2 mark, but the amount of getting a 0 mark for that particular question is 75%. So you have to restrict the amount of bluffs which you are doing. You have to make sure that you are sure or a pretty much sure about that particular question. Now, once you are going through the question, if you are having a question which you are sure, totally sure about it, then please go and mark it properly. don't keep it at the end to mark the question, because if you have just left that particular question with the marked answer in your question paper, or if you are marking it with a pencil, then at the exam, at the end, if you don't have time to fill up the bubbles, that question will not be checked if you are having it with a pencil marked. So my suggestion is, if you are sure about, pretty much sure about that particular question, then please mark it up with a black pen. Don't wait for the last moment. I hope this video was helpful in relaxing you a bit in what is CET basically involving, and also will helping you in how to study, how to attempt any question in my CET exam, and how to do your practice work. I will be uploading more videos which will be related to mathematics CET, that is, in which I will be sharing with you some tips on various different topics. To get those, you have to subscribe to our channel so that you can get regular updates on the uploads which are being done. You can go and watch other set of videos which are electronics, engineering mechanics and mathematics, but please do it after your MHCET exam. So thank you. Keep watching and keep learning, and happy learning. All the best to you all.